an army not of the state. For now, the Retribution of Skyra exists amid considerable political tension and unrest. Relations with the government and the Home Guard coalition are far from comfortable. Bolstered by the support of House Nyar and House Shiel, the Retribution recently seized the initiative and forced the Consulate Court to recognize its standing. The government felt compelled to acknowledge the Retribution as a lawful organization, but none of the Haltair are pleased with the outcome. Addendum: House Leadership. Historically, when a single leader led a house, he or she assumed the title of Narsisar, in homage of Narsisar Lysir. After the recent civil war, that title fell out of favor as it was associated with Narsisir Girishade of House Vire. Whether they are led alone or as part of a council, most house leaders today utilize the slightly humbler Incisor title. This derives from the god Osiris, the Incisor of Hours, Sovereign of Conflict, and the General of Laos, and has additional advantages of representing a top military rank. This is appropriate as Incisors are as the top-ranking military leaders of their house armies, whether or not they spend time in uniform during directing soldiers in combat. Consul is a special title afforded to a leading representative to each Haltair appointed to attend the consulate court and speaks for the house on matters of state. Most councils have been Narsisars or Incisors. The leaders of the Haltair can freely nominate any of their peers to sit on the consulate court, including senior advisors or political adept relations. Most enjoy the authority they wield as consuls, however, and are unwilling to surrender this post to anyone else unless compelled by duties, age, or illness. End addendum. Most consuls gave their grudging acceptance after realizing that behind the Retribution's lofty rhetoric about Skyra's fate lurked the threat of violence. Memories of the recent civil war are still fresh, and the consuls have no desire to see Ios torn apart again by internal strife. Lacking the will to oppose the Retribution with force, the consuls had no choice but to accept it as a valid political and military entity, one they agreed could act with minimal consulate oversight. Technically, the councils of House Nyar and House Shiel are held responsible for the actions of the Retribution, but given their political views, it's only an illusion of restraint. The consulate court may have been forced to accept the existence of the Retribution, but it does not endorse nor support this organization. The Retribution is not a state-sponsored force. Such as an army like those of the Iosian's neighboring kingdoms would serve as a direct extension of the will of its sovereign. Although the Retribution does not act for Ios as a whole, humanity will likely see no distinction between the two and is expected to hold the nation responsible for any of the organization's acts of violence. This has led to considerable anxiety in the minds of the more conservative Iosians. The Retribution's leaders, called the Nine Voices, have seized upon the weakness they see in the consulate court and have leveraged it for their cause. They are willing to push Ios to civil war if need be, but were nonetheless gratified that their political adversaries quickly caved into their demands. They continue to press for support from any house they perceive as even remotely sympathetic, pointing to the rising public support for the Retribution and the additional momentum since the news of Nysir's reached Ios. Politically, other Haltair cannot vehemently oppose the Retribution without giving them the impression they do not support preserving the Elven gods. Relations between the Council and the Nine Voices are tense and uncomfortable. There is a mood in the capital of a government being held hostage by radicals. Addendum: Winter's Hammer, Talons of the Dawn Task Force. Drawn from the ranks of the Talons of Dawn, this huge task force and other fighting in support of its goals represent a bold move on the part of the Retribution. The mission of this force is nothing less than the recovery of the god Nysor, believed held deep within Kador's interior by the Grey Lord Covenant. The task force aims to accomplish its objective quickly and efficiently, but is prepared to conduct longer operations should they prove necessary. This goal represents the first priority of the Retribution, and there will be no compromises in terms of military assets sent to ensure its success. Don Lord Vyros Nyar has personally assumed leadership of the Winter's Hammer and intends to prove the strength of the Dawn Guard by relying almost exclusively on his house's army for the main assault. He has handpicked subordinate officers from among the most capable officers of his house, serving closely with several closely related by blood. Raven Eternal Light is leading the special ops companies with support of Vyros' forces, using her mage hunters to ensure the strike proceeds as planned. Vyros has eschewed house guards for the initial strike, reserving that honor for the Dawn Guard. Vyros has made plans, however, for house guard companies to aid in covering the forces' return to secure territory once the mission has been executed. He intends to make use of a variety of feints and ambushes during the retreat out of Kador to hamper pursuit. As the senior mage hunter warcaster, Raven is responsible for organizing these efforts as well as coordinating strike forces during the assault phase. The mission is of such high importance that other task force from Skyra's Blade will be involved in a diversionary attack inside occupied Lyell that should attract Kadorian forces and divert patrols. While the operation will heavily rely on the Dawn Guard with a moderate wing of heavy cavalry support, the core of the force is its Myrmidons. Vyros' soldiers have been drilling for months using a regiment created specifically to prepare them for Kadoran tactics. This operation's secondary priority is to extract a heavy toll on the Greylord Covens without compromising the recovery of Nysor's frozen vault. The Winter's Hammer Task Force contains a van and special operations segments drawn from the Talons of Dawn Army Strike Force. End addendum. Houses Nyar and Shiel. Despite lingering tensions, those suggesting violently quashing the retribution have been overruled. Such a task would have been difficult and a bloody at best. Though the Home Guard Coalition outnumbers the retribution greatly, the extremist numbers are deceptive. IOS and military experts agree that the retribution's forces are disproportionately powerful due to primarily to the involvement of House Shiel and House Nyar's, who bring with them a vast armory of Myrmidons and other Arcanic weapons in the addition to the Dawn Guard. Both houses have for years made little effort to hide their quiet support of the Retribution. Minor sympathies for Ios's fringe religious sects are not uncommon in the political circles. Many high-ranking nobles have always had such leanings. Most houses would draw the line, however, at agreeing to an open and full alliance with the Retribution, which is exactly what both houses have recently done. They have even gone so far as to take the unprecedented step of allocating the majority of their military assets to Retribution services. The truth is that these two Hautayir have been more tightly linked to the Retribution than their peers have ever realized. For decades, they have secretly provided both financial and military assistance to the organization. These houses decided long ago that true change in Ios would require extreme measures. As political creatures they are, these respective leaders of these houses have kept their motives to themselves. These men have not given to zealotry or religious fervor. It is generally accepted that houses Nyar and Shiel back the retribution for pragmatic rather than religious reasons. It is not that their leaders are thought to dismiss Skyra's condition or ignore the gravity of the status of the vanished gods, but pursuing such lofty mysteries is clearly not their primary motive for pursuing the retribution agenda. Those who succeed in leading the cause of salvation will reap great rewards. The political clout brought by the unquestioning support of the people will facilitate the transformation of Iosin society and even the dissolution of the consulate court. This is a gamble for which both houses have committed all their considerable resources. Should the retribution cause continue to spread amongst the population, the other Haut'ahir may feel forced to follow their example or be left powerless in the expected new order.